टुडेज टॉपिक इज लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टारफिश। बिफोर गोइंग इन टू द लाइफ हिस्ट्री ऑफ स्टारफिश, वी शुड हैव अ लिटिल बिट आइडिया ऑफ इट्स जनरल मॉर्फोलॉजी। सो दिस इज पेंटामेरस इन शेप, एज यू कैन सी स्टार शेप स्टारफिश। इट शोज पेंटामेरस रेडियल सिमेट्री। ओके, देर आर टू व्यूज ऑफ दिस एनिमल। वन इज द टॉप व्यू, एबोरल व्यू, एंड दिस इज द डाउन व्यू, ओरल व्यू। सो एज यू कैन सी, ओरल और माउथ इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द ओरल सर्फेस एंड एनस इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द एबोरल सर्फेस। देन इन ईच आर्म देर इज प्रेजेंट एम्बुलेक्रल ग्रूव। सेकेंड थिंग इज देर इज, इफ यू कैन सी द स्ट्रक्चर, मेटल पोराइट इज प्रेजेंट ओवर हेयर दैट लीड्स इन टू द वाटर वास्कुलर सिस्टम और द एम्बुलेक्रल सिस्टम। दैट इज अ करेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ द इकाइनोडर्म्स। ओके, वी विल स्टडी अ लिटल अबाउट द एम्बुलेक्रल सिस्टम। सो दिस इज द मेटोपोराइट एंड हेयर सीलिया प्रेजेंट दैट लीड्स सी वाटर इन टू द सिस्टम। सो दिस वाटर एंटर्स दिस सोलन पार्ट एम्पुला, देन फ्रॉम दिस मेटोपोरिक केनाल इट एंटर्स इन टू दीज रिंग एम्बुलेक्रल वेसल्स एंड ईच रिंग एम्बुलेक्रल वेसल फर्दर लीड्स इन टू द रेडियल एम्बुलेक्रल वेसल दैट फर्दर टर्मिनेट्स इन टू पोडियल केनाल। This podial canal leads into the tube feet. Now there are three part of the tube feet. Upper part, swollen part, is known as ampulla, and ampulla leads into the podium, and podium leads into the down part, sucker. So this is tube feet. Now what is the main function of this umbilical system that is present in this echinoderm? The main function is to help in circulation and locomotion and respiration. After this, we will start with the topic, that is the life history of starfish. Starfish is unisexual, sexes are separate, male and female starfish are present, but they cannot be distinguished externally, so there is no sexual dimorphism. Five pair of gonads are present in both sexes, and the gonads, what is the location of the gonads? Gonads are present over here. So one first pair of gonads is like present over here. So one gonad extends into this arm, the other gonad extends into the adjacent arm. Similarly, over here one gonad is present, pair of gonad, one gonad extends over here and other gonad extends into the other arm. So each arm receives two separate gonad from two separate gonad pairs. After the location, the gonads are attached to the base of the arm and they hang freely in the cavity of the metroporite arm. Then each size of the gonad also varies. It is not same throughout the year. It become large during the breeding season. And all gonads, they open out by the genital apertures. Now we will start with the life history. So male starfish releases sperms in water and female starfish releases ova in water. And sperm and ova, they get fertilized in water. That is why the external fertilization is seen in starfish. Female lays about 2.5 million eggs, and many more sperms are released than this number from the male starfish. Okay, so after fertilization, a zygote is formed that undergoes holoblastic equal indeterminate and radial cleavage. So zygote starts dividing. So this picture is showing that this is the fertilized egg that starts dividing. Blastula is formed. Then this blastula, if we see the vertical section, this is the cavity blastocoel lined externally by blastomeres. Then this blastula gets changed into a three-layered gastrula. Outermost layer is ectoderm that bears the cilia all over. Inner layer is the endoderm that lines this central cavity. This is known as archenteron or gut cavity. And as you can see there, here mesenchymal cells are present from which third layer is formed, that is the mesoderm. So zygote forms this three-layered gastrula, which further changes into the first larval stage, that is the dipleurula larva. So this is the dipleurula larva. So what are the main changes that occurs? This archenteron cavity, it gets differentiated into mouth, esophagus, stomach, intestine and anus. Second thing is a perioral band is formed that bears cilia. So initially cilia, they were confined all over the surface, but now they are confined only to this perioral band in dipleurula larva. So this is the first larva generally found in the life history of almost all echinoderms. Now second thing, after a while this dipleurula larva, it changes into the second larva, that is the bipinnaria larva. Okay, what are the main changes that occur during the transformation of or during the formation of bipinnaria larva from this diplurula larva? First of all, it gets elongated and three lateral lobes are developed. Three pair of lateral lobes are developed on the either side of the larva, and one preoral lobe, this is the preoral lobe, is formed. Okay, so these are the lateral lobes 1, 2, and 3. These are the lateral lobes that are formed, and a preoral lobe is formed in the front. And this perioral band that was present in the front initially, that gets divided into two loops, preoral loop and postoral loop. Okay, so preoral and postoral loops are formed from the perioral band. This preoral loop borders the preoral lobe, front lobe, and postoral loop that borders the lateral lobes, which are three pairs on the posterior side. So this is the bipinnaria larva. So first larva that is formed is diplurula. It locomotes, or it is motile, feeds. It gets changed into the second larva, that is the bipinnaria larva, and after that third larval stage is seen, that is the brachiolaria larva. So this bipinnaria larva gets changed into the brachiolaria larva. This is brachiolaria larva. So what are the main changes that occurs during this metamorphosis? Okay, in brachiolaria larva, these lobes that are present over here, they gets modified into three fixing processes and bearing suckers anteriorly. Then this larva, brachiolaria larva, moves, swims freely and feeds actively, and after about 6 to 7 weeks it gets fixed to a substratum with the help of these suckers. So it gets fixed to a substratum from this side, and its mouth and anus, they gets closed. New mouth is formed on the left side that forms the oral surface later, and new anus is formed on the right side that forms the aboral surface later. And five lobes, they grow out as rudiment. So we can roughly say, so mouth is formed on the oral side, anus is formed on the aboral side, upper surface, and later on five arm rudiments appear. That is a kind of baby starfish is formed, five arm rudiment that later forms the arms of the starfish. And it undergoes metamorphosis. So from radially bilaterally symmetric larva, brachiolaria larva, it gets changed into a pentamerous radially symmetric adult starfish. And again the life cycle is repeated, that is male or female starfish are formed, and then this life cycle, it goes on repeating. Here is a summarized form. So let us revise briefly all this. What happens? Male starfish, female starfish, they shed sperm and ova that gets fertilized in water. Zygote is formed. Then zygote undergoes cleavage to form blastula. Blastula gets changed into three-layered gastrula. Then gastrula forms the first larval stage, that is the diplurula larva, in which archenteron is present, perioral band and adoral band is seen. Then it undergoes free locomotion and actively feeding. After that it gets changed into the second larval form. How it changes into second larval form? Three lateral lobe appear on the posterior side, and on the front side preoral lobe is formed, perioral band that gets divided into preoral and postoral lobes. Then this bipinnaria larva gets transformed into the brachiolaria larva with these changes occur inside the body. Then after 6 to 7 weeks this larva gets fixed, it undergoes metamorphosis, and this bilaterally symmetric brachiolaria larva gets transformed into the radially symmetric adult starfish, and this life cycle goes on repeating. So this is all about the life history of starfish.